You're a developer. You build things with frameworks and tools you love. But when it comes time to go live, you wish you didn't have to go through tons of tutorials and choose from thousands of modules out there. Turning your idea into reality is hard enough. You shouldn't have to worry about deployments too. This is a Rails app. It has standard features like user authentication, image uploading, and background jobs. I'll be showing you how to deploy this app on AWS. We'll start with an empty AWS setup. Our infrastructure builder enables developers to easily provision their infrastructure. You can use pre-built templates to build platforms with a single click. You can also create custom platforms by selecting high-level components you are familiar with to build the platform you want. You get access to components like compute, databases, buckets, and much more. You don't need to have experience with cloud providers like AWS. The complexity is all handled by Ops Maru. For this demo, we'll create a platform that has compute, a database, and a bucket for image uploading. Ops Maru provides you with an easy-to-use editor should you need to edit the configuration further. For this demo, I'll be adding some SSH keys to make sure I can access my platform after it's been provisioned. We'll create a single node setup. We can always come back and edit the platform later if we want to scale up. Once happy with the edits, you can click on Preview Code. This will generate the Terraform configuration that will be used to provision the platform. The code generator is intelligent enough to correctly reference all the dependencies, variables, and parameters. The output is accurate and deterministic, which means it works out of the box. Once you're happy with the output, hit Next, and you'll be asked to put in a repository name. Ops Maru will create a repository in GitHub with the generated code. We'll be running this configuration using Terraform Cloud. I have already connected my repository. If you're not familiar with Terraform, we have a separate video showing you how to connect the repository to Terraform Cloud. We'll begin by clicking Start New Plan. This will run our configuration and show us all the components that will be provisioned. We can also take a look at the cost estimation to see how much it'll cost. The cost estimated will depend on the instance type I chose when editing the configuration. Once we're happy, we can approve the plan and Terraform will begin setting up the platform. We can track the progress on Ops Maru. Once all the components are greenlit, our platform is ready to go. Next, we'll need to configure the application. Once we click Configure, we're presented with the choice of build packs and add-ons. I'll be deploying a Rails app with PostgreSQL as a database, active storage with S3 for image uploading, and good job for background processing. We'll be adding more configuration options to our platform as time progresses. Once happy with the selection, Ops Maru will generate the YAML configuration that'll be embedded into your application through a pull request. Once you've reviewed the configuration, you can choose to merge and the deployment will begin. Once the deployment is completed, we'll go back to Ops Maru and we'll choose to deploy our application. You'll be presented with some options. Choose the branch you wish to deploy. In this case, we're deploying the develop branch. We'll select the web configuration, select the target cluster that we provision, and click Next. Since this is a web application, we'll configure a domain. You'll be given a DNS configuration. Once it's all in place, you can click Validate. A green tick shows all as well. Next, we'll configure the installation. You'll notice that Ops Maru has done the hard work of setting up the environment variables. This was done by the application configurator with the YAML config that was merged into your application. Ops Maru has done the hard work of setting up the database and the bucket for your application. There's just one more thing we have to do here. Since the bucket was provisioned before we could set the domain, all we have to do is hit sync on the bucket and the core's configuration will update. Now we'll sync our installation. Ops Maru will provision the container inside the platform and our application will be deployed. You'll see the migration successfully ran, which means connectivity with the database is working correctly. For the moment of truth, let's head over to the application. You'll notice that it works. SSL certificate was automatically provisioned and all the features like image uploading is also working. Now for the background worker. Let's go back to the deploy step. This time we'll choose the good job kit. We'll be asked to select a parent installation and the cluster. Once all the selections are done, the background worker will be deployed. Let's take a look at the installation. You'll notice that the background worker inherited variables from the parents. This means it'll have access to the same database, bucket, and any other resources necessary. Separate installations means the background worker can scale independently of the web worker. Ops Maru is an end-to-end software delivery platform. It helps you configure your infrastructure and manage the entire lifecycle of your application. There's a lot more to OpsMerge than can be conveyed in this demo. Visit OpsMerge.com for more details and sign up to try it out for free. If you have any questions or require support, please let us know. You can join our Discord and get support from the people who created OpsMerge.